It is Sunday, the 3rd of December, 2017. I'm in front of the Unitarian Church of Montreal, engaged in my alternative spiritual practice of protesting against Unitarian Universalist injustices, abuses, and hypocrisy, with an emphasis on clergy abuse, cover-up and denial of clergy abuse, but also anti-religious intolerance and bigotry that rather too many of the atheist members of the Unitarian Universalist religious community engage in. There's various other issues as well, such as Montreal Unitarians and also the Unitarian Universalist Association misusing and abusing the criminal justice system in efforts to try and silence my criticism of Unitarian Universalist clergy abuse and so on. And you know, we're looking here at a meme slash picket sign slogan that I created a while back to protest against the fact that helpless children have been raped by Unitarian Universalist ministers and Sunday school teachers, also known as religious educators. But the Gazette's retired justice reporter, Sue Montgomery, who happens to be, or at least was, a Montreal Unitarian for some number of years, never reported the Unitarian Universalist Association's misuse of Canada's blasphemy law in clergy sex abuse cover-up legal bullying. That's an entirely truthful statement. Sue was asked to report on the fact that the Unitarian Universalist Association had falsely accused me of the criminal act of blasphemous libel and legal bullying intended to hide pedophilia and rape, and she refused to do so. And prior to that, in 2006, 2007, on several different occasions, I asked Sue Montgomery to report on the justice issues that I am protesting about in front of the Unitarian Church of Montreal. She refused to do so. If we go back to December 2000, 17 years ago, almost exactly 17 years ago, I was arrested while protesting outside the Unitarian Church of Montreal for allegedly violating Section 176.3 of the Canadian Criminal Code, which prohibits disrupting the order and solemnity of church services. So this was a cynical misuse and abuse of the Canadian Criminal Code by Montreal Unitarians, certainly individual Montreal Unitarians, such as Jeremy Searle and Valmir Bourdon and at least one other prosecution witness. But you can be sure that behind them there were other Unitarians involved. So it's open to some debate as to whether this was something done, you know, by and on behalf of the institution of the Unitarian Church of Montreal. It's open to some debate as to whether Jeremy Searle and Valmir Bourdon actually had official approval to do this. But nonetheless, you know, I was falsely accused of violating Section 176.3. And when I phoned up the Gazette to report this false arrest and this misuse of the criminal justice system, Sue Montgomery was the person who was handling the city desk that day. And so I told Sue Montgomery what I just said here. I might not have had the full details. I might not have had the exact charge, you know, but I definitely called the Gazette and said, hey, I've been arrested, you know, for alleged, you know, public nuisance, you know, for protesting outside the Unitarian Church of Montreal, and I'd like you to report that story. And Sue Montgomery insisted that it was not newsworthy. She refused to assign a reporter to report a story about the fact that I'd been arrested for alleged public nuisance for protesting against clergy abuse and so on outside the Unitarian Church of Montreal. So my history with Sue Montgomery never reporting on any aspect of the injustices and abuses and hypocrisy that I'm protesting against goes back to almost exactly 17 years ago. That was when it first began, when Sue first refused to report a newsworthy story about a misuse of the criminal justice system with total bullshit criminal charges brought against me by Jeremy Searle and Val Bourdon and one other prosecution witness whose name I don't remember, but which almost certainly had the full support and backing of the leadership of the Unitarian Church of Montreal. So, somebody got a stick, hopefully. You planning to hit me with that stick like you did before? You planning to give me a good whack with that stick like you did before?
Will you please get out of my way?
I'm not in your way. Look, the whole sidewalk's there. Oh, you're doing it again. Another Unitarian falsely accusing me of blocking access on the sidewalk. Well, thanks for that false accusation, madam. And thanks also for not whacking me with your stick today. That was a very, very foolish thing to do. But it's also very, very foolish to falsely accuse me of anything, including blocking the sidewalk, when I'm doing no such thing. One other idiot accused me of blocking the sidewalk earlier today. So thanks for upping the ante here, Madame Freud. So this, you know, little old lady actually had the unmitigated gall to whack me a couple of times with her stick some months ago, and I confronted her about that. And so when I saw her with her cane today, I just had a reminder about that. You know, oh, are you planning to hit me with that stick again, you know? And so what did she do? She accused me of blocking the sidewalk, except I was standing off the sidewalk. I was on the grass when I said that. You know, she walked right by me with no problem, and you could easily see that the sidewalk was totally clear. You know, I mean, it's just insane what some of these Montreal Unitarians do and say, you know. Truly foolish, you know, when I got a video camera running to record all this shit, you know. I mean, that's why I have the video camera running almost constantly, is because Unitarians do this shit. You know, I don't know how many times I've been falsely accused of blocking the sidewalk. You know, I've had SPVM cops come here and accuse me of blocking the sidewalk because they've received false complaints from Unitarians about me blocking the sidewalk. Now, I've had Unitarians walk right up to me, even though they've got plenty of room to pass me, and falsely accuse me of blocking the sidewalk. That's happened on a certain number of occasions. Bob Wright did it. Kenneth Howard QC did it. Who else? There's a few others. You know, this whole bullshit about me blocking the sidewalk is just foolishness on the part of Montreal Unitarians, like Vera Freud, who I just had a little chat with, and David Rollert, who I had a chat with earlier today, you know, accusing me of blocking the sidewalk just because my picket signs were partially blocking some of the sidewalk. But it wasn't blocking all of the sidewalk. There's lots of room for people to go by, and if anyone felt that my picket signs were in the way, all they had to do was say, could you please move your picket signs, and I would. You know, so just foolish, incredibly petty accusations brought against me by Montreal Unitarians. But that leads into even bigger false accusations. You know, false accusations of disrupting the order and solemnity of church services. False accusations of committing the criminal act of blasphemous libel. So on and so forth. You know, just the false accusations are just insane, literally insane on the part of Montreal Unitarians. And the last time I checked, one of the Ten Commandments said something like, thou shalt not bear false witness against thy neighbor. I seem to remember that. I think there was a movie with Charlton Heston playing Moses, and that was one of the Ten Commandments that he spoke about, you know. So you don't have to believe in God to believe that that's not a bad little commandment there. Like a pretty good life rule, like don't go around making false accusations about people. Because it might come back to bite you in the ass, you know, amongst other things. You know, but it's very, very harmful. Making false accusations about people is harmful not only to the people themselves, but, you know, their friends and family and so on. It can reflect badly on them as well, or they can, you know, it can cause all kinds of problems. You know, it's basically, you know, making false accusations affects the whole society, you know, and if people just stopped making false accusations about other people, if they were, you know, only made truthful accusations that were supported by evidence, well, a whole lot of crap would, like, disappear. You know, half the tweets on Twitter would probably disappear. I'm exaggerating a bit, but, you know, there's lots of misrepresentation of the truth on social media. You know, you got the Republicans saying one thing, you got the Democrats saying the other thing, and, you know, sometimes they're telling the truth, but often they're at minimum exaggerating, you know, or they're giving a misleading half-truth. I think one of the worst ways of making a, you know, bearing false witness against someone is to tell a misleading half-truth. Because, you know, yes, you're telling the truth, but you're not telling all of it. You're, you know, yes, I was blocking the sidewalk somewhat earlier when I had my picket signs down on the sidewalk and I was talking to David Rollert. But there was still plenty of sidewalk left for people to walk by me. So I wasn't really blocking the sidewalk. I was just partially blocking the sidewalk. And anyone who walks on the sidewalk is partially blocking the sidewalk. The guy up ahead there with the suitcase is blocking as much of the sidewalk as I was with my picket signs. You know, the Montreal Unitarians who park in the bike lane and open the door of their car across half the sidewalk and get out of the car are blocking the sidewalk completely. I don't see David complaining about them blocking the sidewalk. You know, no, it's just making spurious bullshit complaints about me. So he can maybe call in a complaint to the SPVM and say, oh, we got this protester outside and he's blocking the sidewalk. Come and get rid of him. You know, I mean, I've had that kind of shit happen before. Thankfully, partly because I'm running video of everything now, the interventions from the SPVM have significantly decreased. In fact, this year, which is almost over, there's only been one intervention. And if I remember correctly, and it was a nice one, by the way, basically nothing to complain about in terms of this year's one time where a police officer from Station 11 just basically asked me some questions about the protest, didn't object to anything, didn't in any way try to intimidate me into ending the protest. He was very nice. He even said that if I have any problems, you know, feel free to contact Station 11. I have zero complaints about how he intervened. But that was the only intervention this year. That was in May. There were a few times where vans and cars came by. There was one where it looked like there was going to be some kind of intervention, but it didn't happen, just about a month ago. But in terms of a police officer actually saying something to me, that was the only one. And then if we go back before that, the only other one in 2016 was on May Day of 2016. And that one was a bit problematic because essentially the police officers involved were in fact trying to intimidate me into ending the protest. They essentially told me that Montreal Unitarians were looking into bringing more criminal charges against me, and if I wanted to avoid that scenario, that I should just end the protest. That's essentially the upshot of what they were saying. And amongst other things, they said, on Peu Upgrade A and others, we can, you know, turn up the heat. And I said, oh, Peu Upgrade A, moi-même aussi, you know, like, I can upgrade too. You want to upgrade? I'll upgrade, and we'll see what happens, you know. So that was the last time they intimidated me, more than a year ago, 18 months ago or so. And the interventions in 2015 and 2014, for the most part, were pretty polite and professional. I really have little to complain about in terms of how SPVM cops intervened in 2014 and 2015, but they shouldn't have intervened at all, really. But when they did, you know, when they were called to the church by bullshit complaints, you know, from John Inder and so on, they handled it quite well. Not perfectly, but I give them an 8 or 9 out of 10 for how they handle it. And most interestingly, in terms of how they could have handled it better, I'm actually glad that they didn't. Because what they should have done in terms of the John Inder incident, you know, they totally upheld my rights. They said, yes, you can have chalk slogans. Yes, you can have freestanding picket signs. Yes, everything's fine. But the Unitarian Church of Montreal has a right to erase your chalk slogans, and we don't want any incidents or trouble when that happens, you know. And my response was, hey, no worries, you know, if they want to erase my chalk slogans, I'll just film it. And I'll just have proof of how they, you know, cover up clergy abuse and so on, you know. So I couldn't care less if John Inder wanted to make a total fool of himself by coming out and erasing my chalk slogans, and I could film him doing it and have evidence of John Inder being a knowing and willful participant in cover-up and denial of such despicable crimes as pedophilia and rape committed by certain Unitarian Universalist ministers, to say nothing of other Unitarian Universalist injustices, abuses, and hypocrisy. So I really wasn't concerned about that tiny little lapse, because what they could have done and should have done was to say, you know, if they really wanted to keep the peace and everything and really wanted to avoid conflict, they could have said to John Inder, well, yes, you can erase his chalk slogans, but you have to wait until he has left the area and his protest is ended. You should not erase his chalk slogans during the protest while he was here. So that was the one little thing that the SPVM cops didn't do that they could have done, which would have made their intervention almost 100% perfect, as far as I'm concerned. But I'm glad that they didn't. I'm glad that they didn't tell John Inder not to erase my chalk slogans while I was still there in order to prevent any possible conflict. You know, I'm glad that I was able to film John Inder erasing my chalk slogans, you know? That's video evidence of John Inder being totally complicit in his religious community's immoral and unethical and borderline criminal, if not actually criminal, clergy abuse cover-up efforts, you know. So I'm very happy to have that video footage. So I'd like to thank the SPVM police officers who had that little minor lapse of professionalism. Who knows, you know, maybe they deliberately did that. Maybe they wanted me to have the opportunity to film John Inder, you know. Who knows what they were really thinking, you know. But they were very nice. They totally respected all of my rights. In no way intimidated me, and I got some nice video footage of John Inder erasing my chalk slogans and making modern art out of them with, it looked like sort of tie-dye kind of stuff on the sidewalk, so no problems with those cops. I even titled the video A Polite and Professional SPVM Intervention, because that's what it was. And yeah, so there were some previous interventions as well in 2014. They weren't too bad. You know, the cops were pretty good. No complaints. It was really 2013 and earlier where the cops were...